What is going on, guys? We are back for another episode of Pokemon Top 5s. This week, we'll be covering our top 5 Gigantamax Pokemon. In the last few ones, we have done Shinies, we've done Variants, we've done Mega Evolution. And so it was only fitting that we wrap this up, this little session of them up with Gigantamax forms. So, of course, as always, guys, this list is 100% opinionated and, of course, always subject to change. But if you have a different top 5 than me, make sure to leave it in the comment section down below. While you're down there, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss out on any other top 5s that we do here on the channel or any Let's Play content that we do as well. So without further ado, though, let us hop in to number 5. Okay, so at number 5, we have Centiscorch. Now, Centiscorch is based off of an Omakuadale. I don't know how to say it in Japanese, but it's a colossal centipede of Japanese myth, and it kind of describes a thousand resembling legs of a thousand torches, and so you can kind of see the resemblance a little bit. Obviously, Centiscorch is the tallest bug type Pokemon. It is also single-handedly the tallest Gigantamaxing Pokemon, and the Gigantamax, like when it gets sized, basically it adds 100 legs and it makes it actually move really, really fast. And so it's a really cool Pokemon. Obviously, it increases, it gets to a 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit, which obviously is enough to like completely disrupt air currents and storms, right? So, but to me, this Pokemon is super cool. They took a really nice, like, I'm not really the biggest fan of Centiscorch in terms of, like, I'm just not a big fan of bug-type Pokemon, but I have to respect what they did here with Centiscorch. It kind of looks like Mushu a little bit, you know? A little bit like Mushu, but, and obviously you see in the photo here, just a Riolu taking on a Centiscorch, which is unreal. But, yeah, I mean, Centiscorch, to me, the design is super cool. I think the things on, like, the yellow part of its body are supposed to be, like, heat burners, which is kind of cool as well. But yeah, I mean, design-wise, Centiscorch is absolutely unreal. When it goes into that accordion-looking thing, it's a little weird, but I kind of like it better in the anime where it kind of stood up and did its thing, right? But that is our number 5 designed G-Max form, but let us move in to number 4. Okay, so at number 4, we have Gigantamax Butterfree, and Butterfree obviously is a really, really cool design. I actually like, if they would have actually kept its wings like this in its normal form, I actually would have really, really liked that. I think that fits so much better. This is one of the ones where I'm like, this is the design you should have gone with, just rocked out with. But yeah, obviously G-Max Butterfree has several green scales that kind of float around it. Basically, what it is, it's the crystallized G-Max energy, and it actually uses them with its psychic abilities, and they cause paralysis, they cause poison or sleep. This is kind of the ability that Butterfree has. What is it? I don't know what it's actually called, but it's, and obviously, with it being so big now in this Gigantamax form, it can actually just gust away a 10-ton truck, which is kind of wild. Obviously Butterfree was a Pokemon that really needed some love. You know, it got a lot of love in the anime early on, and then it kind of just fell to the wayside. There's been so many other like butterfly Pokemon, and so kind of getting back to Gen 1, they really kind of did a lot of justice for this little butterfly here. But without further ado, let us hop in to number 3. Okay, so at number 3 we have Gengar, and of course Gengar gets all the love from Pokemon. We already know this. Gengar in its G-Max form is crazy. It actually doesn't grow to the same height as other Pokemon. It actually just comes out from under the ground, which is kind of cool. You know, Gigantamax and Gengar's mouth is rumored to not lead to its body, but because of the cursed energy, it leads to the afterlife, which is absolutely unreal lore. I love it. Ghost types, again, have the coolest, coolest energy. They have the coolest backstories, the coolest lores. And it's trying to basically just steal the lives of those it captures. So basically what is said is that people can hear voices of their loved ones calling out to them inside of its mouth, so that it will, so the person will be tempted to walk in. And of course Gengar kind of leaves the shadow element and starts turning into like an absolute like harbinger of death here. But obviously the design is super, super cool. I really, really like it. Obviously you've seen people now, like they have the sleeping bags and the hats. Super hilarious, super funny. G-Max forms, I think some of them, they took a more serious approach. Some of them took a little bit more comical approach. I think they did this with Alolan forms as well. And so I really like Gengar's design. Obviously Ash is using one in the anime as well. And so it's a super cool design. Hopefully we get to see a little bit more of it. But this is one of the best Pokemon, and G-Maxing just makes it that much better. And so without further ado, let us hop in to number 2. All right, so at number 2, we have Alchemy, and I think this is a Pokemon that has kind of gone under the radar a little bit, but G-Max Alchemy, G-Max Garbodor, they have very interesting designs, very unique designs. I think Alchemy's I just liked better. Obviously, being the whipped cream on top of a cake is crazy. And the cream just pours endlessly from its body, which is crazy. And so when it gets hit, it just attacks. It has like a better defense, which is kind of cool. Obviously based on a wedding cake, and it has 64 different versions of it, which is unreal based on the amount of Alchemy flavors there are. And the decorations on it are hard as diamonds. And so, as you can tell, this thing ends up being quite bulky if you include the cream and the diamond kind of accessories on it. And so for me, that's just really, really cool lore. Design wise, to me, it's one of the better ones. It's one of the more unique ones, one of the ones that I think they put the most effort into designing. And so for me, it just got a lot of respect from me here. And that is why it is number 2 on my list. But without further ado, let us get into our number 1 slot on this week's top 5 G-Max forms. Okay, so at number 1, we have Orbeetle, and Orbeetle is one of the coolest ones out there. I really didn't expect Orbeetle to look like a giant UFO at the end of it. To be honest, because it starts out as like this little like caterpillar with like a bow tie and stuff, and you're like, what is happening here? But obviously G-Max Orbeetle is unreal design. Its psychic powers are now so overwhelming. If it even uses a slight bit of power that it has, it can control the minds of every living being in vicinity, which is unreal. The lore behind that is so, so cool. And for me, the design wise, I think they knocked this out of the park. This is unreal. The fact that like you have the glow from the G-Max form, you get the neon like thing like down on you, I think it looks so, so cool. It's such a cool design. I think it gets slept on way too much as under the radar, like one of Pokemon's better design things. And so that is why I have it number 1 on the list. But without further ado, that is the end of this list. I think we'll be covering what do we got in on the docket here. Let me just pull this up, fourth wall here. Let's see what we got here. We got the, oh my god, unprofessional, but we have my top 5 still left to do. We have legendary Pokemon still to do, and then I have a couple other kind of unique ones that I wanted to do as well. So We're wrapping it up here, sort of. We're getting to the back half of it, but I hope you guys are enjoying the series, and I'm gonna get up out of here, so I will see you guys in the next one.